that same song here, I lift up my hands, I lift up my voice. I am sure that you lifted up your voice because there was no voice. Amen. So let's mean it when we sing saints.
Amen.
Let us mean that song.
Yes.
And just by singing that song, friends, see, when we sing the song, we should lift up our voice, we should lift up our hands, so that our worship should go up. Because we realize what good things He has done. And we should know that what is going outside and what is happening outside, still we are safe. We realize
it.
And we should worship.
Yes.
I should open my mouth, oh worship.
Hallelujah.
But I should lift up my voice, I should lift up my hands, and I should give the glory that today I am here. I am not dead and gone, but He has kept me alive. Still He is protecting, and He will continue to protect me. And that should be my faith. And I know the Lord is with us, Lord is with His children, and He is always protecting us. There will be many more things happening. But when we are in the hands of the Lord, we know that He will protect us. And we are thankful to Him. We appreciate what He is doing. Let our heart rejoice that we are with Him and He is with us. See, it is a common understanding of a man that something great should happen. A big splash or a big something miracles. Or something startling should happen in my life, and then only I'll believe. That's what we think. Many people, they think like that only. Oh, see, that church is full of crowd, full of miracles. Many people go there, and that's what people think. And they are attracted more to the Lord. But you know, today I am going to tell you something, that He does the work in a quietness and in simplicity. That is His method. He does it. See, we know the scripture that in a still, small voice, He speaketh to His children. And what is happening, saints? We go for that. That is a human tendency, that we keep on watching for such things. Oh, that is so powerful. Something happened, that preacher is shouting and preaching so loudly and all these things. And we go for that, but we never understand how the Lord is working in our own life. And He works in the simplicity, and I'm going to prove that today, that how is His work. His work is very simple and in the quietness, and He does that. And there are many great things what He does. See, I will take the example of Mary and the birth of Jesus Christ. This is very simple. Don't tell me that we have taken Mary's name, it is all for the sisters, but it is for everyone. We all should realize that God is working in our life in a simple way, in a quiet way. Sometimes you may experience this when you are coming here in the house of the Lord. Sometimes we have problem, we go through a situation, we have some sufferings, we have some questions. But if your heart is true upon the Lord, if you are faithful, while the message is going on, you will hear, you will get the answer from the message or from the word of God. God does that. God speaks to His children. He doesn't speak with a loud voice, but He gives us somewhere. See, it is not only the preacher, but somebody talks with you. It may be small child also, because out of the babe, the Lord speaketh. And He does speak. See, here if you take the example of the Mary. Now, it was very simple and in the quietness what God had did in her life. God chose her because God's hand was upon her. Today God's hand is upon us. He has chosen us to be His children. And He does many things in our life, but we don't realize, we don't understand. And that's what we have to today understand, that what God is doing. And if I commit myself in the hands of the Lord will do many more things. So here in the Luke, which we have read that many times, I don't want to turn more to the more scriptures today, but what he did, it was the greatest work what man can understand. And that is very simple. Where was Jesus born? Right? Where was he born? He was born in the manger. That is a simplicity. And that's what he said, that a Christ, a child will be born to you. His name will be Emmanuel. And all those things, we have gone through this lesson many times. But how was that talk? Angel came, Gabriel came and talked to him, talked to her, and he just spoke with her. But still, she had a doubt in her mind, because that is her nature. Anybody can have that doubt. How it is possible? Sometimes we have doubt that what God will do in my life. And in that doubt only, we don't trust in the Lord. We don't believe. But when Gabriel talked with her, then she said that, "Let thy will be done." And I know that she is so humble there. And in that quietness, in that simplicity, Mary realized that what good hope the Lord has given to me. That was a great hope and great faith upon the Lord. She was God-fearing. She was always with the Lord, praying and doing every good work. And God chose her. And her faith increased when angel came and talked with her. It was a simple talk. It was in quietness. And God told her that what is going to happen. Here in the Luke, let me turn to some scriptures here in the Luke, the second chapter. And God, let us think on this, that the great miracle what he has done. See, that was not a big shout, that was not a big issue what had happened, but it was a great miracle what God did through his son. He was born in the manger. And that was a great miracle. And sometimes it happens in our life. In the simplicity and in the quietness, he talks to us. When you are praying, in the small voice, sometimes he talks to you. But we are blind. We don't understand that. That's what I want to encourage you, saints, here. That let us think what God is talking to me. And we pray, we listen to the messages. But are we listening carefully what God is talking to me? Yes, we come here, we sit here, we listen. But does that work in my life? If I am faithful to the Lord, and if I am humble, and if I have that hope that God is talking to me in that simplicity, then you will understand what God has spoken to you. See, you may get many good messages. We may go through the Daniel, Isaiah, Jeremiah. We may go through all that. But if I'm not faithful, if I'm not listening what the Lord is telling to me, don't you feel that when somebody is on the Bible stand and talking to you, is it not the Lord who talks to you? Are you listening to that words? No. We listen, we sit here, we listen. But when we leave, we go out of the door, we forget everything. But in that period, God had talked to you in such a way, God had shown you, in some areas God has touched your mind, touched your understanding, but you don't look what God has done to you. Because you want a powerful message, something great to happen, something miracle to happen in this place, and then only you will believe what God is doing. No, but God, whenever he's here, whenever we are here, his presence is here. And God is touching his men, his ministers, to talk to us. Listen some messages very carefully, saints. And God talks to you. God tells, God shows that what I have to do. I'll just give a simple example that I went through a message. That Jonah was sent to Nineveh. You have believed that? Do you know all that? I hope you know.
Yes.
He sent Jonah to Nineveh. Where? To whom? To Syrians? Am I right on that?
Yes.
Say yes or no.
Yes.
He sent Syrians. But you know, Jonah didn't go there. Why Jonah didn't go? And I heard through this message and God talked to me. Because in Jonah's mind, because sometimes I'll talk on that more, I'll put that lesson here. But why did Jonah didn't go there and visit those people and tell what God wanted to tell? Tell me. He didn't go because he had something in his mind. All the time he had that thought that they are very cruel people, evil people. They do all evil things. They tortured God's children. They tortured many Jewish people. And that was in his mind. And he said that, why I should go to them? But you know something? Though they were cruel people, though they were evil people, it was in the mind of God to save those people. Because that destruction was going to come upon those people, but God gave them a chance. That's what he did when he was speaking to Abraham. And Abraham was asking, if there are 5 people, if there are 10 people, he was all that. You know all that story. I don't have to go more deep in that. But it is in the Lord's mind, it is in the God's mind to give an opportunity for a person, for a soul, to save himself and come back to the Lord. Who are we to stop that? If you have something against somebody in your mind, just wash it. Just take it out. Allow the Lord to touch your heart so that you'll go and talk to that person. You'll have nothing in your mind about anybody. Because something somewhere it might have happened long back. Same thing happened with Jonah. Then again God, and we know what all happened. God calls him again. When I have told you why you are not going. Sometimes God talks to you. I don't want to go more deep in that. But this is the way where God talks to us. And we just neglect. We want to see something more powerful from the Lord. But the small things we forget. And here Mary, she was humble enough to listen what God wanted to tell her, what angel wanted to tell her. Here in the second chapter, verses 6 and 7, let me read that here. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes. Where was this birth taken? In a big hospital? Big 5-star hospital? No. But he was just in the manger. There this birth took place. So in that simple way, God works. This is a great example for mankind. When God comes to each one of us, see, he comes to each one of us, but we don't realize. We don't think on that. We are still doing our own things. See, we know that many times we have read that what should be my life? How I should have the changes in my life? What image I should again create in my life? The image which has been defiled. God is telling me, see, it is only this God who is giving us this opportunity to change the image in which you were created. We were not created what we are like this now. But we were created in his own image. But because of the fall of a man, we have been defiled and we are fallen. And we do the things what still we are doing. And this is the image of this world, of the devil, where he has put us in his chains, in his bondages. But our God is so merciful. He wants to come us back to him and change the image by changing our life, changing our spirit, changing our attitude and day-to-day life. But you know, these are all the scriptures, these are all the messages, the letters from Paul. But we don't take it. That is God who is talking to you. Now who has given this word? Isn't it under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit? Isn't it the truth? This truth is the foundation of my life. Do I have taken that foundation of the truth to build myself? But we want something different, then only I will believe. God should come in my dream. He should show me some vision, some miracles, some healings. Then only I will believe. No, but in a small voice, He talks to us sometimes. So, and this is the great thing, that in the simplicity and in the quietness, God does His work. And same work was done when Jesus took birth here. And as we know that he's always with us, He is talking to us. But we fall short to understand what He is talking to us. Because we are engaged in our own things. We are in that our own self package, warped up with the worldly things. That's why we are unable to understand what God wants to do in our life. God does many things in our life as we mature. See, this is common understanding, and this is common thing for mankind, that where was Jesus born? And that was very simple. And as we grow in the Lord, as we become mature in Christ, the mighty work which God does in our life, it takes me towards the perfection. And see what simple work He did for Jesus Christ, for His birth. The same simple work and quiet work He does in my life. If I believe my Jesus, if I am faithful to Him, it works slowly in my life, and a day will come in my life when I become complete mature and fully grown in the Lord. Then I have all that patience, I have all that long sufferings, I have all that understanding which Jesus has. Now, when this was told to Mary, what she did, she said that, yes, it is. See, again here in the, somewhere it begins with the, she said that, I think it is 38 verse somewhere, same chapter. And she coming in that instant gave thanks likewise unto the Lord. No, I'm just sorry. It was at 138, I'm sorry. See, the scripture was there in my mind. 138. And when she was told what is going to happen, she said, yes, Lord. And Mary said, behold, the handmaid of the Lord. Can we say this to the Lord today? We are just simple. And let your work be done. And she said, but be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from him. Sometimes God talks to us through that small voice. He makes us to understand, come on brother, this is not right. Come on sister, this is not right. What you are thinking in your mind, oh, this is going to happen, this will happen, this will happen. But somewhere somebody talks to you and he gives you the answer. Come out from that thinking. Don't put thoughts anymore in your mind. But what happens, you don't accept it. See what Mary said? According to thy word, let it happen. So when somebody talks to you, let it happen. Come out from that things which in which you are bounded. I have to come out that. I have to pull my head. See, I have seen many people for many years. They are in the same thing. They are in the same problems. Oh, what will happen if that will be done there? What will happen? It was happened some months ago. That was the mistake. But you know, let us trust the Lord. He is there to forgive you. He is there to bring you out. And through many talks, through many scriptures, he shows you, he proves you. And that time I should say that, Lord, let your will be done, because I am your servant. And that's what she accepted, what was told to her. And then she was faithful and she was honest to the Lord. And her hope was, she realized that my hope has increased and God will answer my hope. And then she started to take care what was told to her. How much we take care when we are told something to us through the scripture or through the word of God. Do we do that? That's what I was telling you. We come here, we listen everything, but we leave the things and we go off. We forget everything. And I want every child of God here. This lesson is for me also. That when God shows me something, see, I do some wrong. I do many wrongs. It is not that I am right. I do wrongs. There are many things in me also. But sometimes if it is brought to my notice, I should think on that, why it has been brought to my notice. And I should accept it, I should work on that, and I should bring it out. So when I believe in the Lord, when I trust in the Lord, this the simplicity and the quietness, quiet work of the Lord, it begins in my life. Now how it starts, once I accept the Holy Spirit, which is given by Jesus Christ, through that Holy Spirit, it works in my life. And it makes me, slowly it works. And in that simplicity and the quietness of that Holy Spirit, it works in my life. Because of the Holy Spirit, I come to know what is right and what is wrong. And then I become mature and I grow in the Lord. And that's what God does in everybody's life. Only thing, we have to submit ourselves in His life, in His hand. Then here in the first chapter again, let me come back here. Verse 30. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with the God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb. We know this scripture. He shall, now 32nd, he shall be great and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of the father David. There are many things which has been promised to you and me today. Do you realize? There are many promises in our life. The greatest promise is that he is going to take us into his kingdom. Right? One of the promise, what he has said, that you are called, you are chosen before the foundation of this world. See, this was the promise which was given to Mary, and her faith was increased. She was simple, but she was faithful. And in her quietness of her life also, she did what she was supposed to do. She took care of that special child. She brought in that child in the proper nurture. When we have something which has been given by the Lord, I think we have to take special care of that. When if you are baptized in the Holy Spirit, that is a promise which has been given to you, that I will send the Holy Spirit which will guide you, which will lead you. That's a great promise which Jesus has given. And some of you, some of us, we have received that Holy Spirit. Then are you still growing in that Holy Spirit? Or it was only that first day? Or sometimes you get that little touch. If that Holy Spirit, if you are receiving, I have to protect that. I have to grow in that Holy Spirit, because that is a great promise. And through that Holy Spirit, if I work on my life, definitely the other promises which are on my way, I will take that. I will have that. And one of the great promise That is, I have to enter into the kingdom of the Lord. And this, see, the things which are happening around, is there no promise of the Lord that I will hold you in my hand? I will protect you in my hand. I'll put a covering on you. No evil will touch you. No any pestilence or whatever it is says, you go through the scriptures and you will come to know that how God is protecting his children. And that is a promise. But we only say, oh, it is a promise that God will protect. But what I am doing, what is my life? Do I take that Holy Spirit and take care of that? I believe the Mary was all the time taking care of Jesus Christ till he was completely grown up. I'm sure. She must be praying with him. She must be doing everything where she should take care of the child. We should also take the care of our children. We should also take the care what the responsibility has been given to us. And if only we understand that God is doing something in my life, then I will realize that yes, God is helping me. And I want that God should work in my life more and more. I should grow in His Holy Spirit, which will take me and lead me. And this work has been done quietly in my life. And this is a very simple work which God wants to do. See, when Jesus told her, when Gabriel told her that you are going to receive a child, you will give a birth, that was her first she had a doubt. Sometimes we have doubt. But then she accepted that and she started meditating upon that. She had her hope was increased, and towards that she started to do her work. And that's what we have to do in our life, friends. See, first of all, let me tell you that you are here today because He called you. He has chosen you. That is His simple work. That's the quiet work that we are here today. And I want to be more faithful, and without any hesitation, I want to accept what God is doing in my life. And let us ask the Holy Spirit to touch us, help us. And when this was happening, we can see something happen in Mary's life. And she accepted all these things. She prayed and she said that let thy will be done. But because of her willingness and the revealed will of the Lord, which was spoken by Gabriel to her. Now there are many things which are revealed unto us, and we have to go and search for all that promises. And how we can do? Through the Holy Spirit, we can study, we can go to the truth of the Lord and help us, and help ourselves. And then the more work we do, the Lord will also reveal us more things. And that's what we have to do in our life. And I appreciate the Lord that we are here and God is blessing us. See, that seed was put in her life through the Holy Spirit. She even realized that it is God's seed. That is the Holy Spirit, holy power of the Lord. The seed of God which is in me. I have to take care. I have to protect that. And her hope was more in the Lord, and she realized that she is the child of God. Can you put that in your mind and tell the Lord that, Lord, let your seed be there in my heart? What is that seed? That is the Holy Spirit. Once you are called, you are justified. The Holy Spirit, what you receive, that is the seed of the Lord. You are no more of the world, but now you are a redeemed child of God who is going to be sanctified for His kingdom. And that seed should come in your heart. And that's what the seed was sown in her heart. See, I'll just read that. But the seed of hope was planted when she believed without doubt. This is very important. That's what I wrote it here. See, the seed of hope should be sown in our life. If we don't doubt, then only it can be it can be sown in our life. She didn't have any doubts in her mind. First she asked that question, but that was not a doubt. That how it is possible, because I don't know any man. But then she understood that it is the seed of God, and with the power of the Lord, she can be conceived. And that she took it, she accepted, and there was no more doubt in her heart. When we are here in the church, when we are called, when we say that we have been called by the Lord, and now we are children of the Lord, no more the children of the world, that seed should remain in my heart, and there should be no any doubt in my life that what God will do in my life. No doubt, saints. Once He has brought us here, once He has called us here, we know that we have to give ourselves in His hand, and the Holy Spirit, which will receive that seed, that holy power of the Lord, which is working in my life, I will grow into that maturity and grow into that understanding that I am in the hands of the Lord. Then my life will be changed. I will no more remain in the same things. How long we are going to remain the same thing? How long we are going to manifest the same spirit? Let me tell you, saints, if we have this hope, if that seed of the hope is sown in you, that what God is going to do, your family life, your personal life, your everything will be changed. You will be more fearful, and you will walk towards the Lord, saints. All your nasty, dirty habit, whatever we have, that will be taken away. Then we'll have that humble spirit, a broken heart, a contrite spirit, a meekness, all the attributes which Jesus Christ had in His life. And we should have that. And when we learn from Mary that faith and hope, what we learn, that she had faith and hope, and what we can learn from that. The first thing what we can learn is the responsibility of raising God's own son. That was her responsibility. She realized when she came to know that the seed of God has been sown in her heart, in her womb, and she was responsible to take care of her. And you know, sisters, they know when you are conceived how much care you take. So when sometimes God puts His seed in our life, that's the Holy Spirit. If you are filled with the Holy Spirit, then I should realize that it is God's Spirit which is in me, and I have to take the responsibility to protect that Holy Spirit in my life. It's very important. The scripture says, quench not the Spirit, Holy Spirit. But we do the things what we are not supposed to do. You mean to say that Holy Spirit is still there? No. Maybe it is left and I am nobody to tell that. But this question is for you, saints. You yourself ask this question. The moment you act funny, or you shout, you scream, or you fight with somebody, you quarrel with somebody, anywhere. Let me ask, immediately I should ask, is it that Holy Spirit which is in you? Is it the seed of God in me? That means I am not taking responsibility to protect that seed of God. But Mary took She took all the responsibility to bring up that child, to take care of everything. Many would need plenty of faith and hope for the days ahead. See, the days which are going to come, they are very dangerous days. You don't know what is going to happen. Nobody can tell it. What somebody made that statement? The pandemic is going to become epidemic. That means it is continuing. It will continue. And along with that, there will be more virus, more things will happen in the world. And we are talking about this present situation. What about those seven last plagues? They are so horrible. But if the seed of God is there in your life, you will, right now, you will start protecting that seed which is put in you, and you will be with that Holy Spirit, and Holy Spirit will be working in you, and you are faithful, your hope is increasing that my God will protect me. The God who has put his seed in my life, the Holy Spirit which is in my life, that will be protecting me in the things which are going to come ahead. Increase your faith, saints. Come on, let us leave all that beggarly elements and walk towards the road which God has given to us. Let us change our life. Let us change our lifestyle completely. I know it is high time now. Let us break on ourselves on that rock before that rock comes and falls on us. I want to break myself. And I want to take care of that seed, that Holy Spirit, which has been planted in my life. There are many trials, there are many sufferings which are going to come ahead, and what I will do that time. Let us fill more and more with the Holy Spirit, saints.
Amen.
Let us glorify His name. Let us worship the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is not, saints, that I just stand quiet on my seat, on my place, and they're just looking here and there. No, saints, the moment the band gives us number, let us
Amen.
Lift up our hands
Amen.
And tell the Lord, oh Lord,
yes.
Fill us with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Yes. Fill us with thy glory, Lord, because we are Amen. Your children. There
yes.
are promises
Amen.
Which has been given to
Amen.
You, given to us, and we need that. We want to
yes.
protect that promises. We want to protect that Holy Spirit, Lord.
Yes. Amen.
And Lord, give me understanding.
Amen. Glory to
God. God will keep. God is there to provide everything in a simple way. He will help you, which you will not realize also. This was all in the simple way which was done. Jesus Christ, He took birth in the manger. That was a very simple thing. And Mary realized that what God has done. And she knew that it was God's work. She realized. Today I should realize what God is doing in my life. You are born in such a family, the family which is God-fearing family. But still I am living the way I am living, saints. No, saints, we have to come out from all those things. Then the second thing what we can learn from this, it is God who chooses us. See, it was... We have not walked here of our own, but it is God who has chosen us today to be here. It was God who chose Mary for the birth of Christ. Now we are chosen by God, and God will take care of us. He will touch us with the Holy Spirit. Here in the sixth chapter of the same book, sixth chapter, verse 44. For every tree is known by his own fruit. For of thorns men do not gather figs. Oh, I'm sorry. John. I'm here. John, the sixth chapter, verse 44. No man can come to me except the Father which hath sent me draw him. I am not here because of my own decision. No, but it is Father who has brought me here. It is God who has brought us here. See, and I will raise him up at the last day. It is written in the prophets. It is written in the prophets, and they shall be all taught of God. We have been chosen, we have been called, the Father has guided us here. We are here because of him, and he will teach me everything. Every man therefore that hath heard and hath learned of the Father cometh unto me. But you are still learning your own things. We are not learning the things which Father is teaching to us. And if we learn of the Father, then only we come to Jesus, we accept him. We have to be taught. We have to take the words which God has given to us. Let this words touch our heart today, saints. Because we are not our own, saints, but God has chosen us. You are precious people. We know the scriptures. Peculiar people, precious people, chosen unto the Lord, unto God, for his kingdom. You want to live the same life? No, saints, but we want to be something special. Taking the seed of the Lord in my life, and Mary took that care. Mary took care of herself till she gave the birth to Jesus Christ. I should take, when this seed of the Holy Spirit is sown in me, I have to take care of my life till I am in the kingdom of the Lord. That is my birth in the kingdom. Can you take that? By living the style of your life? By doing the things what still we are doing? No. But God has sent that Holy Spirit so that with that Holy Spirit we can change. Let's change it. Let's work on our spirit, and God will help us, and God will put that new life in. And many things are there, friends, and many people have allowed ourselves. Mary allowed herself simply, and she with that simplicity and with that hope and with that faith, she allowed herself to the Lord, allowed herself in the hands of the Lord to work upon her, to use her. See, she gave herself because God chose her, and she realized that why I am chosen here. It was God's will. Can you think sometime why I am here? Why somebody else is not here? But I should realize that it is God who has chosen me. Amen. And according to that, I will have no doubt in my life, and I will do the things in my life. Though the circumstances of life, what we are going through right now, but still we have that hope that what God is going to do us. Many people, there, when Mary was conceived, many people might have kept name. Many people might have done that. So there are many trials, there are many sufferings. But if we have that faith in us, through all these things which are still working in our life, we go through these trials. We go through this suffering. But if that seed is there, if I know what God is going to do, I will trust more in the Lord and do the things of the Lord, and God will help me. Then the third thing what I wanted to say here, just let me touch here in the 15th chapter of the John. Let me just read that scripture, 15th chapter and verse 16. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give you. It is he who hath chosen you, not you yourself. If we believe in that, if we are faithful to the Lord, and we have that hope that God is going to do everything in my life, God will help me. Then the third, next thing what we learn, God continues to add faith and hope through simplicity and calmness. He adds that. He puts on giving us that faith and that hope and that all that what we need to go towards that kingdom of the Lord to prepare ourselves. He puts that, He supports us, He gives us that which He is supposed to give us. But if we don't accept and if we do the things, God will not do that. So let us listen in that simplicity what God is speaking to us. Let us take that for us. Then the next thing what I have learned from this lesson here says, here in the second chapter, coming back here in the Luke, I'll just stop here because this lesson is very nice lesson, but because of the time I cannot just touch all the scriptures here. Here in the second chapter and 16th verse, here, and said unto them that sold those, Luke's second chapter, 16th verse, and they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger, and when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning his child, and all they had heard it wondered at those things. But 19th verse, I want to put more light on that. See, but Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Now we hear many things. We hear many messages. We read many words. We do everything. But what word is used there?
Ponder.
Ponder. What is in Marathi? Vichar. Manan. Manan is the right word. Do you go and ponder on that? No. I don't know. You ask that question to yourself. Do you go and ponder on the things which has been told to you? In a simple way, God talks to you. See, sometimes, I know that sometimes if I have some questions and I come with that questions, I come with some problems, some thinking, something in my mind. See, I'm not perfect. Everybody is like that. Sin. That's a human kind, human attitude. They come, they walk with the worries, with the problems. Something happens in the family. Something happens in the house when you are going right. When you are going walking to the church, and with that same thought you come and sit here, but here somebody stands here, and through the message, just in one sentence, you get the answer. Have you experienced that? I have experienced that. Then who was that? Was it not God? In the simplicity and in the quietness, He spoke to you. And that's what I have to learn since. I don't want, He will not visit you in a big splash, in a big miracle, or big startling things, or big crowd. No. But just in a simple way, He will talk to you. And there are examples in the Bible. Elijah, I think it was Elijah, in a small voice. Who was that? Small hand or small voice? Huh? Elijah. God spoke to him. And like that it happens to us also. So I appreciate the Lord said, go and ponder on this word.
Amen.
Put Mary in front of you and see what she was and what I am. Amen. May the Lord bless you.
Well, saints, thank the Lord once again for this opportunity that He has given us to gather together once again. And I would like to thank the Lord for His spirit that we felt here and moved in our midst. As I say, it's always a blessing to worship the Lord with His saints together.
Amen.
And the Lord was merciful to us. He's things are slowly but surely bringing us together back once again. And let's not lose the habit of praising the Lord. So let's continue to lift up our hands and praise the Lord and give Him glory in the house of the Lord. And then the words that Brother Methuselah gave us here today, and how when you talk about the simplicity of Christ, it was not in a big big scale that he was born in a, it was not a big show that he was born in a palace, but he was born in a manger, wrapped in swaddling clothes, and that's where the shepherds found him. And that's how Jesus lived. He didn't live in the palace. He lived in the street. Grew up in the streets of Nazareth. Walked in shoe leather. I mean, there was no halo around his head where people could see, oh, that's Jesus. That's someone. That's the Son of God. No, he lived a very simple life. And that's why even Paul made a statement to the church of Corinth in 2 Corinthians chapter 11, is it where he says, I fear lest by any means the Satan, as he beguiled Eve, that he will also corrupt your minds from the simplicity that is in Christ Jesus. He didn't come up with great, he didn't do any miracles when he was a small baby. He didn't grow up doing miracles. So no, he was just like an ordinary child. But on the inside of his life, something was growing. As he was growing, the Holy Spirit also was growing in Jesus. And that's what, saints, we need to understand. Even when the scripture talks in Luke, I believe, where Jesus was brought before Herod, in Luke the 23rd chapter, and Herod was so happy that Jesus is come. And the scripture says he was so happy to see Jesus that he expected Jesus to do some miracle. Everybody wanted Jesus to do a miracle. Everybody. Yes. Only then they would believe that he is the Son of God. Mm-hmm. And Herod was expecting Jesus to do a miracle, but here Jesus was standing with his hands cuffed, with his robe torn, with sweat maybe on his face. But did that make Jesus little less? He was still the Son of God. He was still the Savior. He was still the Messiah. And that's what Herod missed. He wanted Jesus to see a miracle, Jesus do a miracle. And this is what again the scripture says in somewhere in one of the Gospels, John, I believe the second chapter, he says, and many believed Jesus because of the miracles that he did. But the next verse says, but Jesus did not commit himself unto them, because he knew all men. What do we come to church today? To see a miracle or to see our life changed? See, again the scribes, lots of thoughts were going on in my mindset. Again the scribes and the Pharisees, it says, in Matthew chapter 11 or 12, it says, they asked Jesus, Lord, shall we see a sign? What is a sign? Shall we see a sign, something that you'll do? Jesus said, an evil generation and an adulterous generation seeketh a sign. But then he gave the example of Jonah. He said, the people of Nineveh will rise up in judgment with this generation and condemn this generation. Because the people of Nineveh didn't see Jonah doing a miracle, but they still repented. And Jesus said, a greater than Jonah is standing here, and you still don't want to repent? You want to see a sign? Then he said, the queen of the south shall rise up in judgment with this generation and condemn this generation. Why? She didn't see Solomon doing a miracle, but her heart was touched when she saw Solomon's ascent and descent and his worship in the temple. Her heart was touched. It was not a miracle, but her heart was touched and moved, and she went back changed.
Amen.
Saints, whenever we come to church, let's come expecting a change of life, a change of attitude, a change of thinking, a change of our heart. Let's come here expecting that. I don't mind if Jesus heals me or not. I don't care if my prayers that I'm praying are answered or not. But Lord, I want to have the mind of Christ. Lord, I want to have the love of Christ. Lord, I want to see Christ reflecting in me a little more today than he was reflecting yesterday. That's the greatest miracle that can happen, saints, where God changes our image from a worldly image to a heavenly image. That's the greatest miracle that happens in the life of a child of God, where he or she is not the same anymore, but they have a little more of their Savior's life emanating from them. What a life God has called us to. That's the life that God wants us to live. Miracles, whether it happens or no, it's okay. It's okay. Miracles are not a good foundation. It's only a good sign. But the word of God is a good foundation. We are built on miracles and healings. No, we are built on the apostles and the prophets. That's the foundation. And Christ's life is the chief cornerstone. Miracles happen or not, that's for the scribes and the Pharisees and the ungodly people outside. We are not moved by miracles. Let's come up to a higher level of living, saints. Let's not lose the simplicity of Christ. May Christ become a reality unto us. And thank God once again for the church. Thank God for being with us here. Thank God for His words. Thank God for His opportunity, His mercy and His grace. Thank you all once again for being here. Let's all continue to remember each one of our prayer requests. Let's not forget to pray for the sick and the weak among us. Let's continue to remember them in our prayers, and let's continue to pray for the safety of all God's people, God's children, all our elderly saints, all our young ones, every family. Let's continue to remember each and every one of God's people, our brothers and sisters, in our prayer. Let's not forget any one of us. Let's remember each and every brother and sister in our prayers. And then the body of Christ, the ministry, brother and sister St. G, let's remember them in our prayers. They've sent their love and their regards to each and every one of us. So let's pray for them, and let's pray for the church. Let's pray for the body of Christ. Amen. Let's all stand up and thank the Lord for this time. Heavenly Father, once again, thank you for this time that you have given us. That you have given us, Lord, an example for us, Lord. We just don't have commandments for us now. We have an example. The example of our Lord and Savior Jesus. Lord, you be with us. Continue to give us more grace, O Father. Continue to open up our eyes of understanding. That we will not be moved, O Father, by the things that happen out in the world, O Lord. We are not moved, O Father, by the things that the world is moved by, O Lord, but we are built upon the foundation of the prophets and the apostles, and with Jesus our Christ Himself, the chief cornerstone. O Lord, we don't want to move away from the simplicity of Jesus. Lord, help us to follow the Lamb. Help us to see the footsteps of Christ in every situation that we are in. Father, our wall and our images be restored back, O Lord, the image that you have created man in, O Father. Let our spirits, O Lord, blend with the Spirit of Christ. Let our thoughts and our attitudes and the intents and the motives of our hearts, O God, O Lord, be the ones, O Lord, that move Christ and through Christ and in Christ, O Father. Be with us. Lord, we love each and every saint, O Lord, each and every family here in this local church in our precious hands. Continue to touch everyone that's sick and weak among us, and bless their lives, O Lord. Reveal, O Lord, to them more and more about you, O Lord, and that condition that they are in, O Father, and more about themselves, O Lord. And heal them, O Father, in their physical conditions, O Father. And be with all the churches in the body of Christ, the ministry. Brother and Sister Sanji, cover them. Father, keep them, O Lord, in good health. Deliver them from every evil, and continue to have your hand upon their lives. And be with each and every one of us as we leave. Father, help us all this week. Help us to have a godly week, O God, till we come back again Wednesday night. Be with each and every one of us, and our family members, and our children, O God. In Jesus' name we ask and pray. Amen and amen. God bless you.